Hello everybody, in this particular video I am going to discuss about how do you know your GPAT preparation is going good way or not. So how you can know everything I am going to discuss in detail in this particular video. So first of all, here I mentioned some of the important bullet points, so I am going to explain every important point in detail. So first of all, if your preparation is going in a good way, you get the mixed symptoms. So you have mixed symptoms of confidence as well as mixed symptom of fear. So why you get the confidence, why you get the fear, I am going to explain. So if your preparation is going good, you get the confidence because you already know that okay, I read this much portion of GPAT syllabus, so you get the confidence. But at the same time you get the little fear also. Why you get the little fear? Because you get the fear about GPAT exam by thinking about that there is a chance of getting any questions out of the thing what I'm not read. So this is your fear. So that means if you are prepared well, means you feel these symptoms, so that itself saying that your preparation is good. But the students who are not preparing well, they are having only fear in them. But if you are getting confidence and little fear, means so your preparation is going in a very fruitful manner. Don't worry much more about the exam and read the things, so you definitely crack it. So that is the first symptom. Another thing, that if you are not getting good score, means that is not telling that your preparation is not good. Okay, if you are not getting good score, then also your preparation is very well. So that means if you are not getting good score, means lot of students saying that sir, in mock tests or in online tests or in class tests, I am getting very low score. So that means my preparation is not good. No, your preparation is very well. But thing here is that if you are not focusing on the mistakes what you are doing in that online test or in that class test or in that mock test, that means your preparation is deviating. Not getting good score is also good, but if you are not focusing on the mistakes what you are doing in this particular online test or particular mock test, if you are not focusing on your mistakes, means that itself saying that you are deviated from your preparation. Okay, so lot of students are confused with these two terms. So they are confusing that if they are getting good score, means sir, I'm not doing well, right? So that is the reason I'm getting good score. They are approaching like me. No, if you are not getting good score also okay, but if you are not focusing on the mistakes what you are doing, if you are not focusing on the topics what you not cover, and if you are not covering the something, if you are not focusing on them, then your preparation is deviating. But getting low score is not saying that your preparation is not good. Okay, so in mock test I will give 100 questions, but in the GPAT exam, from that 100 question only one question come, may you know the answer for that one question, right? So that itself saying that mock test marks will not implicated in your GPAT exam. But if you are not, mock test will help you to identify the what are the drawbacks of your preparation, what are the mistakes you are doing in while answering the questions, and what are the topics you not covered. So this will give entire detail. So if you focus on that, means your preparation again very very good in GPAT exam. But if you are not focusing on that, so after writing online test, lot of students what they will do, means they just leave the things, so they never think about the exam what they written, they never think about the mistakes what they did, and they never think about how to correct the mistakes. So if you are the person doing like that, so your preparation is somewhat deviating from the GPAT like. So this is the thing. Another thing, that I'm not interested to do revision. So lot of students also have not interested to do the revision. So if you are the person who is not interested to doing revision, so it is saying that you may deviate little bit about your preparation, because if you are not do the revision, automatically you not remember the things, because in GPAT we read lot more things. So that is the reason you always need to do the revision. If you are not doing the revision, automatically you are little bit deviating. So that means please do the revision frequently, so that your confidence and your memory, everything will be improved lot. So that is the thing. And not having hunger to grab the more knowledge. So if you want to crack the GPAT, means you are learning entire pharmacy syllabus in less, if you are reading entire pharmacy syllabus, and if you are cracked GPAT, means that itself is saying that you have maximum grip on your syllabus what you read in pharmacy subjects. Okay, that means if you are not having hunger to grab more and more knowledge, so it is also saying that you are little bit deviating. Then we can also correct it, and we can develop the hunger to learn. So if your preparation is going good, means what are the symptoms? You may have confidence, you may have little fear, but if you are doing the mistakes also, it is well and done. But if you are not correcting that mistakes, means it is not good in your preparation. Another thing, that focusing on the mistakes is a very important thing, and not interested to do revision is also very important sign of your preparation going in a good way. And having hunger to grab more knowledge, and not seeing any like reasons. So a lot of students saying reasons are, this is the reason I'm not getting, this is the reason I'm not getting, so my teacher is not teaching well. So if you are the person saying the reasons also, you are not interested to do the preparation in a well way. So don't tell the reason, do the work hard, you surely crack the GPAT. I hope you understood. Thank